think particularly of an 11-year-old girl that was hospitalized after having been the victim of an explosion. She had lost both her legs, she had a complicated fracture of her wrist, and she was hospitalized with her mom and two sisters who had also suffered devastating injuries in that explosion. It's hard to imagine how that mom must feel, how she is going to take care of her daughters after suffering the kind of devastating injuries that she has. I was working with my colleagues to help to set up a new hospital in Rafah in order to be able to decongest some of the public hospitals that are so overflowing with patients and with families taking refuge that it's difficult for them to follow up with patients and especially to continue doing the life-saving surgeries that are needed because of the continual and indiscriminate bombing. The blockade is severely limiting our ability to take care of patients. One of my focus was to establish our mass casualty plan, knowing that at any point there could be a shelling in the neighborhood resulting in a mass casualty incident, an influx of patients to our hospital. And I was able to put together about half of what would normally be in a mass casualty kit for the kind of victims and numbers of patients that we are seeing on a daily basis in this war.